Hey, welcome back. It's Brad Taylor at Taylor Coach and Tracy's RV Center in Millgrove, Ontario, Canada. Now, this is a new coach, a 2014 15-footer that we've been talking about the last few videos that we've been wanting to get out to you. We finally got it all together here. What's sort of new for us is a few things that it, being a 15-foot, it now has a side door. compared to a lot of our trailers in this range, size of a rear door. We will also show in some of our new models that all have side doors. All in the nice radius, still have the big window on the side that you see in all a lot of our rear door 14s and stuff like that. Nice size awning on it. And a really great layout inside, giving you lots of living space on the inside and that. You'll be really impressed with the inside. So hey, let's go on board and we'll take a look at the inside. Hey, now we got you on the inside. Something I wanted to sort of note on this particular coach is all the living space here when the coach is back up into its regular position. So there's a very big open floor space. So when you're coming in with your groceries and different things like that, gives you a lot of room inside. This is very similar to all our, say, 14 footers that have the rear door where we have the overhead bunk area along with the couch here. And to show you this trailer is 6'6" wide. So it's still in our narrow coaches, and the bed pulls out to a 54. And to show you sort of how it works, when this goes to pull out to a bed here, you can sneak it by her. Our cushions go down. And the way we've sort of designed it is that if this is designed to be left into a bed, it still gives you access to walk in and out of the coach without the bed bothering you, trying to get in and out of the trailer because you still have floor space. And considering this is only a 15-foot trailer, that you have a 54 here, you have your overhead bunk area that I've showed you on a lot of my other videos that shows for storage up above, along with sleeping kids and everything like that, makes it a very practical trailer without being a big trailer. The other thing that's nice about this, what a lot of people will do, is they will take this during the daytime and flip it back to what we sort of call a day bed. And on a few of my videos there, we did sort of an inside demo of a trailer where the couple had put all pillows around up here. And when they didn't want it into a bed so that we weren't blocking the door at all, this could be a day bed where you could have all your pillows. So if you wanted to come in during the daytime and maybe lounge a little bit, do a little bit of reading or that, we've got our great reading lights that you see in a lot of our coaches and everything. It could be a day bed during the daytime, so you could come in and have a little siesta in the afternoon if you want. And when it comes to the nighttime, you just have to pull it out that last little notch. The back cushion falls down and gives you back to that true 54 by 75. If you didn't want it to a bed at all, again, you could just push it right back and just put it right back into the couch like it always is. So again, it's just personal preference on how you want to use the coach. From there, over on the counter side, which is kind of neat on this particular trailer, what we've done is we've been able to get the counter height back down to our traditional height of a 36-inch counter. Lots of storage underneath here. Got a flip up on the counter to give them an extra extended counter space here, so they've got lots of counter space. We've got a couple of drawers for linens and your cutlery and that, along with we've also made a spot you can put a garbage can or a little recycle bin and that in there. Giving you a nice size counter, lots of storage, sits up, but nice size counter, considering this is still only a 15-foot trailer and that's measured from tip to tip on this particular trailer. We'll get Bob to slip around with the camera here so we can show you the back side of it. Some of the great features here, again, this is very similar to our 14-footer where you have your 6-foot overhead covered with lots of storage up above. You have our dinette that will go back into a single bed, just like you see in our 14-foot rear door. That's why it has the big side window here. So if you're leaving your bed out at the front and you want a place to grab a bite to eat, you can also, this is giving you a place for a bite to eat for the two of you with leaving your bed out. What we've done at the back here, which is kind of neat, getting the fridge from away on the counter and moving it up so there's not that bending down to get to the fridge all the time. The fridge is up in the air here, so it's accessible from the back, so there's no bending over to get to the fridge. You got a nice size freezer. It is still that 2.7 cube Dometic that we've been using for a while with lots of great storage in it. And for a closet, we've kept up the fridge and put a nice closet rod here for all your hanging of clothes, so you have a nice size closet. Excuse me. When you're looking at, you know, our hanging space of what we need is about 38 inches of hanging space. So you got a nice size closet underneath. And the back corner here, what we've got tucked in, is they went with a bathroom area where they didn't want a shower in this particular trailer. So they've gone with just a built-in toilet. So there is no shower. You can get them with showers, though. That will be an option on them. But it has just your built-in toilet. They've done a few neat things they've asked for, though. We've done a medicine cabinet in the bathroom here. We've got a little flip-up shelf here, so that if they want to put a basin in here for doing a little bit of shaving or brushing their teeth or anything, even though there isn't a vanity in the bathroom, they have all those options in here, considering that it's still just, like I said, that 15-foot. It's a ducted heat system, so we have a register into the bathroom here. We've got a few registers into the coach themselves down on the floor. Up on the dinette area here, we've got it blowing heat up at the front, so the coach is very evenly heated as well. So it's pretty neat on that avenue. And they do have a lot of features, from air conditioning to the TV antenna to solar on this trailer. You can see the TV bracket on the wall here for their television and stuff like that, for watching television on board. So they've got pretty well all the features on this trailer. They do have hot and cold running water because it has an outside shower. It doesn't have an inside because they didn't want an inside shower, but it would have been something if they had asked for it was available at the time. And when we put this particular trailer on the set of scales and weighed it with all the features that were on this particular trailer, it came in at 1,872 pounds, the trailer came in weight-wise, which is a really great weight considering all the features that are on this trailer. So once you put your camp gear and everything on this trailer, you're going to be somewhere maybe around 2,200 pounds on the road traveling, something like that, I would anticipate. Depends on how much stuff you're carrying. If you got any questions on this particular layout and you want to give us a call, you can send us an email or you can reach us by our phone number there. Again, it's Brad Taylor at Taylor Coach and Tracy's RV Center. I really look forward to hearing from you. I hope you enjoyed the video. Watch for some more videos down the road. We've got some more still coming up in some of the 2014s that we're building that are going to be very interesting looking units. And I hope to be hearing from you. Hope you have a great day. Take care. Bye now.